Hey, this is the Black Belt Panda, and welcome to Redstone Bunker 2.0, Episode 1. Now, the idea of this series is the same as the last one. I want to teach you guys how to use redstone. So, unlike other redstone tutorials where they show you how to build a redstone contraption, I want to show you how they work, right? And why they work the way they do. So, by the end of this series, you should have a basic enough understanding of redstone to start making your own redstone contraptions. So to get started, we're gonna wanna find a place that has like a one block level up hill like this, right? And another one behind it would be ideal, but of course you could always place these yourself, do a little bit of manual terraforming. The first thing we're gonna wanna do is dig down right in front, and we're gonna start working on our secret entrance, right? So we're gonna go down two blocks here. So we've got three blocks now. See that? Three blocks of space. And we're going to dig out four blocks. So that's two, three, four. Okay. And then three blocks in this direction. So one, two, three. And then just cave out in between here. So now we've got a little room in here that we can start building the redstone contraption for the secret entrance. Now, the first thing we want to do is set up an item catching system. The way this is going to work is you're going to throw an item and it's going to open up this hole here and you'll be able to go down to your bunker, which is going to be further down below, of course. So in order to do that, we're going to place a dropper right here facing that way. Okay. And then on top of that, we're going to place a hopper. On top of that, a powered rail. And then on top of that, a minecart with a hopper. So a hopper minecart. Okay. And now the cool thing about hopper minecarts is they can pull items through the block above them. They have a larger radius to collect items than a regular hopper does. So if I throw an item on this block, the hopper minecart picked it up. It went down through the hopper here. So this hopper pulled it out of the hopper minecart. Okay, and then this hopper inserted it into the dropper. So now it's down here in the dropper. So now we have an item collection system that delivers items to a dropper. Okay, very simple. Now the next step we're going to do is place a redstone comparator right there. And what this is going to do is detect when an item is inside this hopper. So when we throw an item up there and it travels down through this system, once it gets into the hopper, this comparator is going to activate. Because one of the features of the comparator is being able to read the contents of the inventory behind it. Now, since only one item's going through, it's only going to put out a redstone signal of one, right? So we're going to put a block here. So now this is going to power this block right here, and on top of that, a redstone torch. Now, let me demonstrate. Throw an item, and you see the torch turn off? Very simple. So because we're powering this block here, it's unpowering this torch. Okay, very basic inverter. That's what that is. That is an inverter. It is inverting the redstone signal. Over here, we're going to place a piece of redstone, a repeater, boom, and another piece of redstone, boom, right there. Okay, and then we're going to set this repeater to a 2-tick delay. There are 4 redstone ticks in a second, so this will take 2 ticks, half a second. So when this block powers, it's going to power this redstone, and it says a signal of 1, so it won't go any further without a repeater. So this repeater is extending this signal. So this has a signal strength of 14 or 15, I forget which. But it's going to delay that signal also by half a second, so this wire will activate half a second later than it would have without a repeater, right? So let's demonstrate that. See how there's a slight delay? And now, the way this system is currently working, with this redstone coming along here, we're powering the block that this redstone is on now, right? And next to that block is that dropper. So the dropper is being indirectly powered by the block under the redstone, which activates it and causes it to spit out whatever item is inside. So now, if we come up here and drop an item, the dropper spits it out for us. Very nice. If we set this repeater here to 1 tick with a 1-tick delay, it'll activate too fast and the item won't have time to get into the dropper, as you can see there. That's why we set it to 2 ticks so the item has enough time to get to the dropper before the dropper activates and spits it out. Now the next thing we're going to want to do is break these two blocks right here underneath this little hill. And this is why we need this hill. It's going to hide our piston. We're going to use a sticky piston. We're going to place it right here and it's going to activate. The reason it activated is this torch is powering this block here above it, which is indirectly powering this sticky piston. And then all we have to do is place a dirt block or grass block or whatever right there. And now when we throw a block, it's going to open up. So if you stand right on here, throw an item, we fall down and we pick the item back up because the dropper spit it out for us. Now it's a little dark in here, so let me grab a torch and light it up for you guys. All right, there we go. So what's happening now is, again, this torch here is being inverted when this comparator activates when an item travels through here, and that is causing the piston to depower, deactivate, which opens up this hole, allowing us to fall through, right? And of course, that item then goes into the dropper, is no longer in the hopper, so this comparator turns off, this torch turns back on, and the opening closes up again. Very simple. So this is our secret entrance, completely done. Let me hop out here, demonstrate it one more time. So you go right up to this block here, look over here, throw an item, and we fall down and pick the item back up. Very, very simple system. So next thing we're gonna do is build down here. We're gonna break down here, rather, as far down as you want your bunker to be, right? So I'm gonna go down a little ways here. It's getting dark. I'll go down a couple more blocks. Why not, right? All right, so then what I'm gonna do is just break out an area here. I'm gonna go probably three blocks in, which way am I facing here? Three blocks in this direction, three blocks in the opposite direction, and then maybe seven blocks in that direction, okay? And then I'm gonna cave out this whole area here to get ourselves a nice little room to work with. And this is what it looks like. So I extended it down by one more block, so it is three blocks tall. It is seven blocks by seven blocks, so it is a nice little square. And these dimensions may change. Actually, they probably will, because we're gonna need more space than this eventually. But for now, this is all the space we need, right? So now the idea is, you know, we fall down here, boom, right? But you'll of course take fall damage by doing that. So we're going to mitigate the fall damage very simply. You'll need a sign and a bucket of water. So if we place a sign here and a bucket of water above that, the sign keeps the water from flowing down and the water acts as a sort of break for our fall. So if I go into survival mode here, drop down, boom, no fall damage, right? Very nice. So that is our quick way down. Now, of course, we need a quick way up. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna come over here and we're gonna break in one block here. And now we're gonna start going up, making a little staircase, right? And we're gonna do this until we reach the surface. All right, so here we are at the surface. We've got this little stairway going on now. And what we wanna do, now that we're at the surface, is we're gonna work backwards a little bit until we have a five block vertical space, right? So that's two blocks, okay? That's three, four blocks. So we need to go back one more. I'm gonna break that block there. I'm gonna move this torch out of the way. I'll fill this spot in here. And now we have a five block space right here. So one, two, three, four, five. This is going to mark where we want to be in order to use our exit. So now we can move back one more block, right? And then we're going to break out an area around this block here. So I'm gonna go back about, yeah, that's good there. Okay, next thing we're going to want to do is this block right here. You know, we can actually move these blocks out of the way for the time being to make it a little easier to work. All right, so this middle block right here, we're gonna break down two blocks, and we're going to put a sticky piston at the bottom, facing up, just like that. Above that, we're going to place a slime block. And now on either side of the slime block, we're going to place a furnace. Now, the reason we're putting a furnace here is because slime blocks will move whatever block they're attached to when they're pushed with a piston, right? So if that piston pushes this block up, it's going to try to move all the dirt blocks on all four sides of it. But we don't want it to do that. Some blocks are immovable, and furnaces are one of the cheapest ones to make, right? So furnaces can't be moved by the slime block, so the slime block will push up without trying to take the furnaces with it, okay? And they only take 8 cobblestone each to make, nice and cheap, and they look nice, right? So next thing we're going to want to do is actually grab a button right here, and we're going to place that on the wall back there. And of course, you could redecorate your walls if you'd like, make them all stone. I'll probably do that off camera in the future. And what we're going to do is start breaking out back behind here a couple of blocks. And we're going to place a redstone repeater behind the block that the button's on. Now, the repeater will pick up the signal from this block, like so. And it's going to power this block here. So we're going to go under that block and place some redstone. So now, when this block is powered, it's going to indirectly power the redstone below it. Boom, just like that. And we're going to carry that redstone down, just like so. And we should be right next to the piston here somewhere. There it is. All right. So we're going to carry it down to this level here. And we're going to place a repeater facing into the block next to the piston, right? And then connect it with the redstone. Now we're going to set this to a 2-tick delay. So we want this to activate a tick after this is activated, right? So this will actually be 2 ticks after, if that makes sense. I'll show you. See that? Half second delay? There we go. All right, so that's going to launch us upwards if we stand on it. Of course, we've got a ceiling in our way here. Try that again. Boom. And that'll launch us up 5 blocks. Very nice. But of course, we don't want a hole in the ground up there, so we're going to deal with that now. And in order to do that, we're going to break up above this block now. Make a little bit of room here. We're going to place some redstone. I'm going to remove some of these blocks. And we want to find this area up here. We're going to go up here. And we're going to take a sticky piston, and this is where we want to come up through, right? So we're going to go back and place our piston right there. Let me fill that hole. All right, so there's our piston. There's the block it's going to push. Let me make that grass. There we go. There's the block the piston's going to push, and that's going to push it right over top of here. We can actually cover this spot up now because we don't need it anymore. Now that we have our piston, there it is. All right, so locate your piston from underneath. And what we're going to do, place a block here. Might as well switch to dirt now. Place a redstone torch on top of it. That's going to power the block above it, which is going to indirectly power the piston. If we come back over here, we can see that it is now closed, right? So that will hide from up above where our exit is. And now we're going to run some redstone straight over to that torch. So when this block gets powered by this repeater, it's going to power the redstone on top, which is going to travel along here, power this block, and turn this torch off. Another inverter, right? Very simple inverter. And that's going to deactivate the piston, causing it to pull the dirt block back, opening up the top. Okay? So now if we push this button, you can see this open, but remember, we put this on a bit of a delay, right? So this is going to open first before this activates. So now if we stand on here and push that button, look at that. Very nice. All right, let me get out of there. Put that back up, land. So you see we get stuck in that block a little bit, right? So in order to correct that, we're going to set this, let's see, one more tick. Oh, I forgot to replace the block. Try that again. And now we're no longer stuck, see? So if you get stuck, just add one more tick of delay, all right? So now we've got it on 3 redstone tick delay. And now it works pretty nicely. We go up. I forgot to replace the block again. We go up and land. Perfect. And now, of course, we want to hide this up here, right? So you want to do some terraforming to make it look like there's a little hill. Make it look as pretty as you want. Doesn't really matter. Most people aren't going to get suspicious about a little spot like that, right? And then, of course, we've got our entrance over here. Stand on that. Down we go. Boom. And then we've got our exit. So you're going to want to put some stairs here to make it a little easier to traverse. And I'll make this stuff look prettier off camera before the next episode when we add some more stuff to the bunker. All right, there we go. Boom. And now to make it a little bit easier to use this, we can actually place some more blocks here. So you could use furnaces again, because remember, that slime block's going to go up a block. So you want blocks that it's not going to attach to. So we put those there. We can hide this here. Hide that there. You could even, if you use like wood for your walls or whatever, where's that? There we go. All right, let me put that there. I'll make it a little pretty for you guys. Just a little. All right, just a little. Build up this wall, build up that wall. All right, there. It's a little prettier, right? It's all dirt and wood, but whatever. I'll make it look better off camera. And now we can come up here and press the button and get launched up. Boom, there's our escape. So we have a working hidden entrance and exit. Works very nice. Boom, I like it. And of course you can mark this area here with like a special flower or something. Something that's not gonna stand out in the biome you're in. Like I could throw a poppy right there and boom. Now the area is marked. I know to walk up to this block, turn and throw an item. All right, so in the next episode, we're gonna start adding some cool stuff to this bunker. I'm gonna make it look a little prettier off camera. And of course you can make your bunker look however you want and put these contraptions wherever you want in them. And that is it for our secret entrance and exit for the new Redstone Bunker 2.0. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please click that like button, subscribe and share, and don't forget to ring that notification bell. This is the Black Belt Panda. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.